Welcome to our channel. This presentation is on environment education. Topics covered in this presentation are Ganga Action Plan, Save Tiger Project and Agenda 21. Let us start with what is Ganga Action Plan. The Ganga is the largest river in India and the second greatest river in the world, with an extraordinary religious importance for Hindus. It is worshipped as the goddess Ganga in Hinduism. Along its banks are some of the world's oldest inhabited places like Varanasi and Patna. It provides water to 20 to 40% of India's population in 11 states. In modern times, it is very known for being polluted. So Ganga is a sacred river for Hindus. It is polluted at a very large scale. Causes of the pollution in the river Ganga: first, industrial waste, religious practices, dead bodies of animals and humans, Haridwar Dam, human waste and municipal waste. What are the ill effects of Ganga pollution? 66% incidence of waterborne enteric diseases occur, include acute gastrointestinal disease, cholera, dysentery, hepatitis A and typhoid. High level of coliform bacteria in the river Ganga makes it unfit for agriculture use, let alone drinking and washing. A study conducted by the National Cancer Registry Program in 2012 suggested that those living along its banks in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and Bengal are more prone to cancer than anywhere else in the country. The survey indicated that gallbladder cancer cases along the river course are the second highest in the world and prostate cancer highest in the country. The Ganga River dolphin is one of few species of freshwater dolphins in the world. Hydroelectric and irrigation dams along the Ganga that prevents the dolphins from traveling up and down in the river is the main reason for reducing the population of dolphin fishes. So what is Ganga Action Plan? The Ganga Action Plan program was launched by Rajiv Gandhi in 1986 in order to reduce the pollution load on the river. It also included the tributaries of the Ganga, namely Jamuna, Gomti, Damodar and Mahananda. What is the main objective of Ganga Action Plan? That is pollution abatement, to improve the water quality by interception, diversion and treatment of domestic sewage and present toxic and industrial chemical waste entering into the river. And other objectives of Ganga Action Plan are: first, control of non-point pollution from agriculture, runoff, human defecation, cattle bellowing and throwing of unburnt and half burnt particles or bodies into the river. Second, research and development to conserve the biotic diversity of the river to augment its productivity. Third, new technology of sewage treatment like upflow, anaerobic sludge blanket and sewage treatment through afforestation has been successfully developed. Fourth, rehabilitation of soft-shelled turtles for pollution abatement of river have been demonstrated and found useful. Fifth one is to act as a trendsetter for taking up similar action plans in other grossly polluted stretches in the other rivers. And sixth one, the ultimate objective of Ganga Action Plan is to have an approach of integrated river basin management, considering the various dynamic interactions between biotic and the abiotic ecosystem. Then comes phases of Ganga Action Plan. Ganga Action Plan is divided into two phases, first and second. First phase was launched in June 1985. It was the first attempt to Government of India to clean the river Ganga. To accomplish this task, a total of 2,061 projects of pollution abatement covering 25 towns in three states, UP, Bihar and West Bengal, were sanctioned at a cost of 462 crores. And the second phase, since Ganga Action Plan first didn't cover the pollution load of Ganga fully, the second phase was approved from 1993 onwards. It included the Gomti Action Plan, Jamuna, Damodar and Mahananda Action Plan. The Ganga Action Plan was not able to achieve its objectives despite a total expenditure of 90,171 crore over a period of 15 years. Reasons for the failure of Ganga Action Plan: first is inappropriate environment planning, second, insignificant cooperation between central, state and local government bodies, lack of local technical expert committees for monitoring the work, improper mass awareness and involvement of Ganga users in different projects, least political dedication and vision to save Ganga, UP, Bihar were not able to provide uninterrupted electricity for running the facilities. Second topic is Save Tiger Project. It is a wildlife conservation movement initiated in India in 1973 to protect tigers. Project Tiger, launched in 1973, is one of our most useful conservation ventures in the recent times. It aims at tiger conservation in specially constituted tiger reserves, which are representative of various biogeographical regions falling within India. It strives to maintain a viable tiger population in the natural environment. Then comes goals and objectives of Save Tiger Project. It was meant to identify the limiting factors and to mitigate them by suitable management. The damage done to the habitat were to be rectified so as to facilitate the recovery of the ecosystem to maximum possible extent. It aims at tiger conservation in constituted tiger reserves falling in regions within India. It strives to maintain a viable tiger population in the natural environment. Then comes work done. In 2008, there were more than 40 tiger project reserves covering an area of over 37,761 km per square. Project Tiger helped to increase the population of these tigers from 1,200 in 1970 to 3,500 in 1990s. However, a 2008 census held by the Government of India revealed that the tiger population has dropped to 1,411. Organization. Project Tiger is administered by the National Tiger Conservation Authority. The overall administration of the project is monitored by a steering committee. A field director is appointed for each reserve, who is assisted by the field and technical personnel. At the center, a full-fledged director of the project coordinates the work for the country. Appointment of independent monitors. In order to have an independent evaluation of tiger reserves, Project Tiger Directorate appointed independent monitors in 2004. Experts were selected for professional background, relevant experience, and absence of conflicting interest in terms of MEF guidelines. Supreme Court has endorsed the selection of the experts. Then comes grading the tiger reserves. On the x-axis, there is percentage of maximum scores. On the y-axis, these are the states shown. And very good score falls between 135 to 180, good scores between 108 and 134, satisfactory 72 to 107, and poor score less than 72. So you can easily see the states having how much amount of score. Tourism as a band. Uncontrolled tourism can affect the habitat of a tiger, which can be seen from the figures. Wildlife protection requirement. Wildlife protection and crime risk management in the present scenario requires a widely distributed information network using state-of-the-art information and communication technology. This becomes all the more important to ensure a desired level of protection in field formations to safeguard the impressive gains of focused project like Project Tiger. The important elements in wildlife protection and control are mapping, plotting the relevant spatial abundance of wildlife animals, identification of risk factors, proximity to risk factors, sensitivity categorization, crime mapping, and immediate action for apprehending the offenders based on effective networking and communication. Technology use. Tiger Atlas of India and a Tiger Habitat and Population Evaluation System for the country is being developed using state-of-the-art technology. This involves mapping, data acquisition and GIS modeling, field data collection and validation, data maintenance, dissemination and use. Positive signs. Professionally prepared management plans implemented with little deviation, anti-poaching camps and daily monitoring, professional thinking, direction and management experimentation, firm resolve among leadership and motivated field personnel, efficient networking with police, district administration and other agencies, concerned efforts at addressing people-related issues. Third topic in this presentation discussion is of Agenda 21. Agenda 21 is a non-binding, voluntary implemented action plan of the United Nations with regard to sustainable development. It is a product of the UN Conference on Environment and Development held in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil in 1992. It is an action agenda for the UN, other multilateral organizations and individual governments across the world that can be executed at local, national and global levels. The 21 in Agenda 21 refers to 21st century. Agenda 21 goal is to help the environment and was agreed at Earth Summit in 1992. Local Agenda 21 is Agenda 21 on local scale, saying think globally, act locally. Aim of Agenda 21 is the sustainable development of society, economy and environment. Structure. Agenda 21 is a 300-page document divided into 40 chapters that have been grouped into four sections. Section 1 deals with social and economic dimensions like international cooperation for sustainable development, combating poverty, changing consumption pattern, demographic dynamics and sustainability, human health, human settlements and decision making. And Section 2 deals with conservation and management of resources for development like protection of the atmosphere, land resources, deforestation, desertification and drought, sustainable mountain development, sustainable agriculture and rural development, conservation of biodiversity, biotechnology, protection of the oceans, freshwater resources, hazardous waste management, solid waste management and radioactive waste management. And Section 3, strengthening the role of major groups. It deals with preamble, major groups, women, child and youth, indigenous species, NGOs, local authorities, trade unions, business industry, scientific and technical community, and last one is the role of the farmers. And Section 4 deals with means of implementation. It deals with financial resources, technology transfer, science for sustainable development, education, public awareness, training, capacity building in developing countries, international institutions, international legal instruments, and information for decisions for decision making. Means to ensure sustainability. First is integration of development and environment at all levels of political and economic decision making. National policies and development projects should take full account of the effect on the environment and include the cost of natural resource depletion in the value of environmental quality in national accounting system. Improvement in the international trade system, waste minimization, biodiversity conservation, use of biotechnology for building natural capital, increase food, feed and fiber production and enhance the overall quality of life. Using precautionary measures to prevent global climate change, taking precautionary measures by using chemicals. And in the end, conclusion-wise, we can see that Agenda 21 is a dynamic program. It has been carried out by various actors according to different situations, capacities and priorities of the countries and regions in full respect of all the principles contained in the Rio Declaration of Environment and Development. It could evolve over time in the light of changing needs and circumstances. This process marks the beginning of a new global partnership for sustainable development. Thanks for watching this. In this video, background voice is given by Ms. Navkiran Kaur and the video editing was done by Mr. Teerajkar. Thank you.